Are you ready to learn Looker Studio? You're in the right place. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to get started with Looker Studio. We're going to cover the steps to create your very first report. We'll look at how to connect a data source. We'll explore the different ways you can visualize data for your reports and dashboards. And we'll also look at how you can begin to customize and style your reports. Looker Studio lets you present data using a range of visualization options. You can use it to create dashboards, multi-page reports, and more. Let's head to Looker Studio to get started. You can find Looker Studio by heading to lookerstudio.google.com. And we can see here that we're presented with some templates at the top, along with recent reports and dashboards we've created. You can also connect different data sources to build your dashboards and reports. Today, we're going to connect Google Analytics, but as we'll see, there are different options you can use depending on the data you want to use. Okay, let's click Create. We can see there are options to create a report, a data source, and an explorer. Let's select the option to create a report. The first thing we need to do is add a data source to our report. To do this, we need to use a connector. This is simply the way we get data into our report. We can see that all of the Google connectors are listed first. This includes connectors for Google Analytics, Google Ads, Google Sheets, and more. Scrolling down, you can find connectors from other partners. This includes a range of connectors from Supermetrics and other connectors. You can use Supermetrics if there isn't a Google connector available. For example, if you wanted to include data from Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, or other platforms, you can use one of these since Google doesn't provide inbuilt connectors for these platforms. You can search for connectors, and you can also select My Data Sources to use data sources that you have previously connected to other reports. I'm going to select Google Analytics as the connector for this report. We can then select the Google Analytics account and the property we want to use for the report. Today we're going to use Google's GA4, Google Analytics 4 demo property, but of course you should use your own Google Analytics property or other data source when you create your report. Once we're happy, we just need to click Add. And then Add to Report. We can see that a table is automatically added to our report. And we're looking at the report canvas, which is where we build our report. Across the top, we have a range of options. For example, we can select Insert or Add a Chart to add visualizations to our report. This includes time series charts, column charts, combo charts, pie charts, tables, bubble maps, field maps, heat maps, line maps, geo charts, scorecards, scatter charts, bullet charts, stacked area charts, pivot tables, tree maps, gauges, and more. Since the table is selected, we can modify this chart using the panel on the right-hand side. We can see there are two columns. The first column lets us adjust the chart. This is where we can change the dimensions and metrics presented in the chart and change the style of the chart. And the second column shows us all of the fields that are available for the data source. So this lets us view all of the available dimensions and metrics we can use. Okay, so we're going to create a single page report that shows us how people are finding our website along with other important metrics. We're going to include various elements from the Google Analytics acquisition reports. Let's start by naming our report. To do this, let's click Untitled Report on the top left corner. And let's give our report a name. I'm going to name my report Traffic Acquisition by Loves Data. Now let's remove the chart that was added by default. To do this, we select the chart and click Delete on our keyboard. And let's adjust the layout of the report. To do this, we can select Theme and Layout on the top right, or we can select File on the top left and then choose Theme and Layout. Now let's select the Layout tab. And under Canvas Size, let's select US Letter Landscape and change this to Portrait. Now we're going to add some key metrics to the top of our report. Let's select Insert, then Scorecard. We can see the chart shows us the total number of views. Let's change this. Let's select Views and search for Active Users and select our new metric. We can now see the scorecard updates and we can see the total number of active users. Next, we're going to add a comparison to the chart. This will let us quickly see if the number of users is increasing or decreasing. To do this, let's look for comparison date range. And let's select None. The calendar pops up and let's select None on the top right corner. We can choose from Previous Period, which will be the same number of days before the current date range, or we can choose Previous Year, which will be the same date range from the previous year. For this report, I'm going to select Previous Period. Then we click Apply. We can now see the percentage change in users compared to the previous period. Now let's copy our scorecard to present another metric in our report. To do this, you can use keyboard shortcuts, or you can select Edit, then Copy, and then Paste. Let's use this scorecard to show the average amount of time people spend on the website. To do this, let's select the metric and search for and select Average Session Duration. Let's copy the scorecard again. And let's change the metric to conversions. This lets us see the total number of conversions that people have completed on the website. Let's copy the scorecard one more time. And let's change the metric to total revenue. And for this scorecard, let's select the Style tab. And let's enable Compact Numbers and set the number of decimal places to 0. This makes it easier to understand the revenue being generated at a glance. Now that we've added some top-level metrics to our report, let's add a table. Let's select Insert and then select Table. And let's change the dimension from event name so we can see our marketing channels. To do this, we can click on the current dimension and then search for Session Default Channel Group and select our new dimension. We can then see the table updates. Now let's change the metric that's presented in the table. Let's select the default metric and change this to sessions. Now let's add another metric to our report. Let's search for engagement rate and add this to the chart. We can now see the table shows us the different marketing channels sending people to our website, the number of sessions for each channel, and the engagement rate. This lets us quickly see our most important marketing channels and if people are actually engaging with our website and content. Now let's customize how the metrics are presented. To do this, we need to make sure we have the chart selected. And then we need to select the Style tab. You'll find a range of options for customizing the chart. For this example, I want to customize the way the metrics are displayed. So I'm going to scroll down and look for Metric 1. Then I'm going to select Number and change this to Bar. we can see our chart updates to show a visual comparison for the metric. Now let's select Show Number so that we can see the metric included in the table. We now have the metric along with a simple visualization. Okay, now let's repeat this for the second metric. We need to look for metric 2 and then change number to bar and enable show number. That's it. Now we're going to copy this table to present other data in our dashboard. Again, you can use keyboard shortcuts or you can select edit, copy, and paste. I'm going to modify this table to show all of the referring websites that are sending traffic to our site. To do this, I'm going to change the dimension. Let's select the Setup tab. And now let's select Session Default Channel Group. And change this to Session Source. Now we can see this does include some referring sites, but it also includes other traffic sources. This means we need to apply a filter to the chart to only include referrals. To do this, let's scroll to the bottom of the Setup column. And let's click Add a Filter. Let's name the filter Referrals Only. Let's leave the filter as an Include filter. Then we need to select a field. Let's search for and select Session Medium. Then let's choose equal to and enter referral as the value. Now let's click Save. That's it. We can see our table is updated to only include referral traffic. Now we're going to copy our original table again. We're going to use this table to present the custom campaigns we are tracking in Google Analytics. For example, our email campaigns and other custom inbound marketing. To do this, we are going to change the dimension. Let's select Session Default Channel Group and change this to Session Campaign. Now we can see there are a number of rows that aren't from our custom campaigns. We can see a row for organic, a row for direct, a row for referral, and one for not set. So we need to create another filter to remove these rows from the chart. Let's scroll to the bottom of the Setup tab and click Add a Filter. We can see the filter we just created, but we need to create a new one, so let's select Create a Filter at the bottom. Let's name the filter Custom Campaigns Only. And let's change Include to Exclude. Now we need to search for Session Campaign. Then select Regular Expression Match. Now I want you to enter caret, backslash, opening parenthesis, full stop, plus sign, backslash, closing parenthesis, dollar sign. This will match any values that start and end with a parenthesis. So this will exclude the organic direct referral not set and other rows we saw previously. You might need to customize this regular expression depending on what you find in your GA4 reports. So feel free to adjust it if needed. I've included the regular expression I've used in the description below this video. Okay, now let's click Save. That's it. We can see our table is updated and the rows showing organic direct referral and not set traffic have been removed. Let's copy the original table again. We're going to use this table to present the landing pages on our website. This will show us the pages people see first when they travel to our website. To do this, we need to change the dimension. Let's select Session Default Channel Group, and let's search for and select Landing Page. We can see the table now shows us the landing pages people have viewed on the website. However, the first row says Not Set. This is showing us sessions and engagement for non-landing pages, So let's add a filter to remove this. Let's name the filter Landing Pages Only. Let's change Include to Exclude. Then we search for and select Landing Page. Select Equal To and enter Opening Parenthesis, Not Set, Closing Parenthesis. Now let's click Save. Now the table only includes landing pages. This is useful for understanding the top entry points and for identifying opportunities to cross-promote offers on our website. Now let's add one more visualization to our report. I want to add a stacked bar chart that shows the overall trend for our top 5 marketing channels. To do this, let's select Add a Chart and choose the Stacked Column Chart option. And let's resize the chart. We can see that the chart is showing us the marketing channels, but I want to see the trend for the date range, so we'll need to modify the chart. Let's start by changing the dimension from Session Default Channel Group to Date. Now we can see that the dates aren't in order, so let's change the sort to date. And then we need to select ascending. Okay, so now we can see the dates in order, but I want to view more days, so let's select the Style tab. And change the number of bars from 10 to 28. Now this chart includes a lot of information, and I only want to see the top 5 marketing channels, so let's change the series from 10 to 5. Finally, we need to change the dimension. To do this, let's select the Setup tab, and change the breakdown dimension to Session Default Channel Group. That's it. We can now see the overall trend for our top 5 marketing channels and a daily breakdown. Before we wrap up, I want to show you 3 more things as you begin using Looker Studio. First, you can adjust the names of dimensions and metrics used in your reports. To do this, we need to select a chart. Let's select the chart we created for referrals. You can then hover over the metric or dimension you want to rename and click on the Edit icon. I can now rename the dimension. Let's name this one Referrals. Next, we can make our report more dynamic by adding a date range control. To do this, let's select Add a Control and choose Date Range Control. Let's set the default date range to 28 days. And click Apply. We can see the date range for the report. And anybody viewing the report can now change the date range. Okay, finally, let's take a look at the default themes available in Looker Studio. These allow you to quickly change the style of your report or dashboard. To change the theme, let's click Theme and Layout. We can now see the default themes that are available. This is a quick way to adjust the overall style of your reports. We've now created a Looker Studio report to understand how people are finding our website using data from Google Analytics. I recommend taking some time to explore the different visualization options you can use in your reports and dashboards. If you would like to learn even more about Looker Studio, then please take a moment to check out the extra resources, other tutorials, and my full Looker Studio course. You can find all of the links in the description below this video. And to stay up to date and learn even more about Looker Studio, please take a moment to subscribe to this channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.